A gene pattern protocol is a step-by-step guide through a typical gene pattern analysis workflow. Each protocol summarizes the aim of the analysis and the steps that will be taken. Each step provides detailed information about the analysis to be performed, both from a computational and a gene pattern functionality standpoint. In all protocols, and in each step of the protocols, you may choose to run the example with our test data or use your own. Using a protocol is a great way to start learning about how to analyze your data in GenePattern. For this tutorial, we will only explore one protocol, keeping in mind that all the same kinds of functionality and information are found in the other protocols as well. So let's say we often work with expression data, and we know we are interested in using GenePattern to cluster that data. On the GenePattern homepage, you find the protocols in the blue highlighted section in the center of the page, which asks, "What do you want to do?" We know that we want to cluster, so we choose Clustering. This opens a small window displaying our chosen protocol. The offset window will allow us to place the window where we can see it as we start to configure our modules. The protocol first gives us a summary of its intent, then asks us to choose what kind of clustering we'd like to perform, and provides a description of each protocol. References for the algorithms are found at the bottom of the page. For this tutorial, we'll choose Hierarchical Clustering. As there are no more decisions to make regarding the kind of analysis we're running, the step-by-step protocol is now displayed, starting off with a brief description of what the analysis does and what we'll get for results. Before we begin, we'll want to take a look at the required input types and decide if we want to use our own data or the example data. If we use our own data, we'll want to be sure it's in the correct format. Clicking on GCT or Res file will bring us to a specific discussion of these file formats. For more information about all GenePattern supported file formats, select the File Formats link under Learn More. For our example, we'll use the provided example.gct file. Our first step is Preprocessed Data Set. The protocol provides us with a summary of the module, considerations for running the modules, a link to the full module documentation, and options to open the module without any data loaded, or to open with the example file loaded. Having chosen to open the module with example data, the original GenePattern window is brought to the front with the module page for preprocessed dataset displayed and the example file pre-populated as our input data. We can then look back at our protocol window to review the considerations and see if we want or need to alter any of the parameters from their default values. For this tutorial, we'll leave the parameters at their default values and run the module. While that runs, we can start to review step 2 of the protocol, which is hierarchical clustering. Once again, the step provides us with summary information, considerations, module documentation, and options for opening the module from that step. Now that our preprocessed dataset job has completed, we'll select the arrow next to its output to send it to hierarchical clustering as input, though we could also have chosen either of the options for opening hierarchical clustering from the protocol. Looking at the hierarchical clustering page, we can again check the considerations for this module in the protocol and make any parameter adjustments desired. For this tutorial, we'll leave them at their default values and run the analysis. While that runs, we'll examine step 3, the final step of this protocol, which happens to be a visualizer. Rather than wait for the example data to finish running through hierarchical clustering, if it still is, we'll choose to open the viewer with example data. There are no parameters to change here, so we can just go ahead and run the visualizer. After interacting with the viewer, we could then choose to save the image as suggested in the protocol. Now we could go back and try this same protocol with our own data, or by clicking on Protocols in the very upper left corner of the window. We could select another kind of analysis workflow to learn about. Using GenePattern protocols in these ways, and any of the ways provided, is a great way to become more familiar with GenePattern, its analysis modules, and common workflows. For more information about GenePattern, please visit genepattern.org.